Destiny 2 Beyond Light is going to bring us a challenge unlike any other time in the Destiny franchise. No, I'm not talking about Aramis, the new fallen antagonist. I'm talking about our weapons and armor being rendered essentially useless in endgame PvE and PvP content. Most of us are probably using weapons that are going to be sunset starting November 10th. So, what are we going to use when the time comes that we can't infuse those weapons and armor anymore? Welcome back to the channel, my name is Man of Coal, and today, let's talk about replacing sunset weapons starting in Beyond Light. If you're new to the channel, my name is Man of Coal, and I make weekly Destiny videos that range anywhere from weapon and build guides to PvP tips and strategies. If you enjoy that type of content, or if you take anything away from this video that's valuable, make sure you subscribe to the channel. We are getting closer and closer to meeting the requirements for YouTube partnership. So every sub and every view helps out the channel a bunch, so thank you for doing that. So I want to start out this video by briefly explaining what my thinking process was behind choosing the weapons to replace the ones that we will go over today. Obviously, there are a lot of good options for each weapon slot in the game, and it would kind of make this video pointless if I just listed every single one of them. So one of my criteria for picking the weapons that I did is that I wanted the new weapons to first and foremost be in the same weapon slot. Kinetic slot with kinetic, special with special, and heavy with heavy. Secondly, I wanted the new weapons to still perform the same or close to the same function as the weapon it will be replacing. For instance, the Mountaintop is usually used for high DPS and ad clearing. I want its replacement to be able to do the exact same thing, pump out high DPS and clear ads. Another thing I want to point out is that every single weapon that is covered today, or at least most of them, have at least one thing about them that make them unlike any other weapon in the game. So, finding a weapon to replace it that does the exact same thing or has the exact same perks is just not feasible. So just keep that in mind before you yell at me through your monitor. Great, with all of that said, let's start off with our good friend, the Mountaintop. Ah, the Mountaintop. It's a love-hate relationship if you really think about it. It's a lot of people's go-to kinetic weapon in PvE because it's just so good for pumping out high DPS and clearing any trash mobs. It's also very effective in PvP on smaller maps because, well, it's a grenade launcher that can one-shot you. But on the other hand, if you're on the receiving end of the Mountaintop in PvP, or if you're like me and kill yourself with your own grenade launcher 12 times during a strike, then yeah, this can certainly be the bane of anyone's existence. But neither of those love-hate scenarios will be the case come November 10th, because the Mountaintop is going to be sunset. And the replacement that I've picked for the Mountaintop is the new exotic grenade launcher, Witherhorde. Witherhorde was the new exotic kinetic grenade launcher that was given to those who purchased the season pass for Season of Arrivals. Its intrinsic perk states that projectiles fired by this weapon blight the target or nearby area on impact. Its other perk states that blighted targets take damage over time and blight the nearby area on death. For those of you that use this, you know all about the blights that this thing creates, and they are very effective. Not only will it do initial damage if you direct impact a target, but it will then create that blight wherever it lands and then continue to do AoE damage to anything that's inside of it. So the Witherhorde is very clearly having a similar impact to what the Mountaintop does. High DPS to targets and trash mob clearing. And honestly, Witherhorde is probably better in a lot of different cases. The obvious difference between the two is that Mountaintop's projectile shoots straight, whereas the Witherhorde's is more of an arc, which could take some getting used to at first. Another plus in my book is that you can't insta-blow yourself up with the Witherhorde, so yay for not blowing yourself up. The next weapon on today's list is probably the most controversial weapon in PvP as of the making of this video, and that is the kinetic sniper rifle, Revoker. The Revoker is another one of those weapons that has a love-hate relationship with the Destiny player base. The main reason being its exclusive perk, Reversal of Fortune, which states that missing a shot returns the bullet to your magazine after a short duration. So, just to clarify, this perk is not taking a completely new bullet from either the magazine or the clip, but rather giving back the bullet that you just missed. Thus meaning, this perk rewards players that miss shots. Now, as someone who almost exclusively snipes using the Revoker, I have to say that this weapon is very much a game changer, especially in 3v3 content. As you all know, every person starts each respawn with two sniper shots in the weapon. Revoker allows players to work around that special ammo economy and theoretically get as many attempts as they need to kill an opponent, albeit they completely miss the shots that they take. So obviously there isn't going to be another weapon in the game that allows players to just earn back that bullet that they completely whiff. But the weapon I'm choosing to replace the Revoker is the Trials of Osiris Sniper Eye of Soul. Not only is Eye of Soul in the same kinetic slot as the Revoker, but it also has the potential to get a decent roll. The roll you will be wanting to get is Snapshot and Opening Shot. If you can add in accurized rounds and arrange masterwork, then that's just icing on the cake. But as long as you get snapshot and opening shot, I would keep it. With Eye of Soul, I'm getting a sniper that can still one-shot headshot opponents, while also getting snapshot, which is probably the most important perk to have on any sniper for PvP. The only thing Eye of Soul cannot do, other than return or miss shots, is one-shot every super in the Crucible. With the Revoker, I knew that I would always have a shot and negate a super because of that one-shot potential. And sometimes, we would win crucial rounds in Trials because of that potential. With Eye of Soul being the same archetype as the Beloved, Bungie changed the one-shot super potential a while ago to no longer be able to one-shot certain high-armor supers. All in all, I'm still getting about 85% of what the Revoker would give me, but with Eye of Soul, I am willing to take that with me into the Crucible as my main sniper going forward. Full disclosure, this next weapon is one that I have absolutely zero experience with, as I don't have this weapon, but I wanted to address it in this video because I know that it's a part of a lot of people's PvE loadouts at times, and that is the Heavy Machine Gun 21% Delirium. Again, I'm not going to spend too much time on this one, as I don't have the experience of using it to share with you all, but to my knowledge, and correct me if I'm wrong, but this weapon is primarily used for clearing out lots of enemies in PvE content, due to its insanely high magazine size and the potential to make it even higher with overflow. So if my perception of how people use this weapon is correct in that it is primarily used to clear out large groups of adds while also probably doing some high DPS, I came up with two options. The first option, if you are still wanting to use a machine gun to replace the 21% Delirium, is another machine gun, and that is going to be the Xenophage. Now, before you say anything, I know that Xenophage isn't a typical machine gun, and it definitely lacks in the mag size and reserves, but first of all, remember, there's literally no other gun like the 21% Delirium in the whole game, so we aren't going to find a weapon that has that kind of potential. But what Xenophage does do for us is give us that potential to clear out large groups of adds. Most of you probably know, but for those of you that don't or just haven't paid much attention when you use it, the rounds you fire from Xenophage actually have an explosion effect to them, as stated by Xenophage's intrinsic perk, Pyrotoxin Rounds. This weapon fires high-powered explosive ammunition. It's not quite the effect that Firefly is, but it can still create some massive AoE damage to massive enemy mobs. Not only that, but this thing hits hard, which makes it good for pumping out high DPS to bosses and powerful enemies. Another positive with Xenophage is that it is an exotic, which means that you don't have to worry about it ever being sunset. Now, I did mention that I had a second option to replace the 21% Delirium, and that second option is the new legendary heavy sword, Falling Guillotine. So this obviously isn't a machine gun, but what it does give us is, again, that mob clearing potential that 21% Delirium gives us. With Falling Guillotine, you can use its heavy attack to turn your guardian into a spinning merry-go-round of death, essentially deleting anything in its path. Add on top of that the incredible high DPS potential, this should be on the top of everyone's heavy weapon list. Make sure you farm for this through the Umbral Engrams this season before Beyond Light arrives. The next weapon we will go over today is one that has recently seen a pretty steady decline in PvP usage, and that is the Spare Rations. Now, don't get me wrong, there are still people who are rocking their God Roll Rapid Hit Rangefinder Spare Rations in PvP, but most people have already gravitated towards its replacement, the Dire Promise. The Dire Promise was re-released back in Season of the Worthy and quickly became one of the most sought-after weapons in the entire game. The combination of great perks and that it was a 150 hand cannon, many people have and still are searching for their perfect god roll. Dire Promise gives hand cannon aficionados that sense of relief moving forward, knowing that they have essentially, and honestly, probably a better solution to spare rations. The Dire Promise is still in the general loot pool for this season, so basically any source where you can earn legendary gear has a chance at getting you a Dire Promise. Another very solid option, and one that I feel is being kind of overlooked, and I have some theories why, is the exotic hand cannon, Thorn. Thorn is, yet again, another 150 hand cannon archetype, landing in that sweet spot of fast time to kill hand cannons. While using Mark of the Devourer and Soul Devourer can significantly decrease time to kill with this weapon, I presume people shy away from Thorn because it is both an exotic and just less trendy than the Dire Promise right now. And I've got evidence to prove it's in fact used less than the Dire Promise. My most recent video, I talked about the PvP weapon meta in Season of Arrivals. And in that video, I researched the weapons that had the most kills in Trials of Osiris for the last 5 weeks. And I found that there were 8 total weapons that appeared on that list for all 5 of those weeks. Of those 8 was in fact the Dire Promise. And you wanna know what weapon wasn't on that list? Thorn. In fact, the last time Thorn was in the top 10 for most kills in Trials of Osiris was back in week 14 of Trials, which was June 12th, where it ranked 10th. And to be honest, I'm not even sure I'm going to count that, because if you remember that weekend, Trials was actually canceled due to some glitch that I honestly can't even remember what it was. So if we aren't counting that weekend, then the most recent time Thorn was in the top 10 for kills was all the way back on May 22nd. Okay, now I'm not trying to dog on the Thorn, but my point for bringing that up was to not be fooled by the numbers. Thorn is still a very valid option to use if you are a 150 hand cannon user. Moving on to the next weapon we will talk about replacing today, Redrix's broadsword / claymore. Now, I know this weapon probably isn't being used very much right now, although with the recent buff to high impact pulse rifles, it's definitely more than what it used to be, but I wanted to include it simply because it is a pinnacle weapon that a lot of people put a lot of time into trying to get. So I wanted to respect that time and effort by giving you a couple options to replace it going forward. The first weapon to replace is probably a pretty obvious one at this point because almost every Destiny YouTuber has covered it at some point already, and that is Cold Denial. Cold Denial is new to Season of Arrivals and is also a high impact pulse rifle archetype. One of my favorite things about this gun, other than its great potential perk combinations, is its super clean sight. I'm a sucker for clean sights, man, let me tell you. Any weapon that gives me a simple red dot reticle with a clear sight to go around it is a winner in my book. On top of that, if you get Arrowhead Break for one of the barrel perks, you'll get a perfect 100 recoil rating, making this thing an absolute laser beam in PvP. Make sure you farm for Cold Denial through the Prismatic Recaster while you can. It is a very solid weapon right now. The second option I wanted to give you is the exotic pulse rifle, Vigilance Wing. Despite being a 5-round burst pulse rifle, Vigilance Wing still received the same adjustments as the high impact pulse rifles did back at the beginning of this season. Now, its optimal time to kill isn't as fast as any of the high impact pulse rifles are, but its body shot time to kill is the fastest out of all of the pulse rifles in the entire game. I would still probably prefer to use Cold Denial, but with Vigilance Wing being an exotic, I thought it deserved some attention for this type of list. Alright, let's get into some of our heavy hitters here. Let's talk about Beloved. Beloved seems to be a very fitting name for this weapon, as it made its appearance in Season of Opulence with the Menagerie loot pool. The thing that made Beloved so beloved amongst the player base was for its very nostalgic feel it gave former Destiny 1 players. To the likes of the LDR or the 1000 Yard Stare, Beloved made Destiny 2 players feel like they had a piece of them come back to life. And ever since then, Beloved has been in almost every Guardian's inventory, slaying out in the Crucible. So right now, I'm put in a situation where not only do I have to come up with a replacement to such an adored weapon, but on top of that, there really aren't many good options to actually pick from that also won't be sunset. I still want to follow my rules that I set out at the beginning of this video, so obviously I can't pick Eye of Soul because that is placed in the kinetic slot, where Beloved is placed in the secondary slot. I can't pick Revoker because that too is being sunset. So what options are there? The only one I was really able to come up with, and that is primarily because it has seen a recent surge in play, is the Ikelos Sniper. Now it's not the same archetype, but it does have some potential with its perk combinations. The capability of rolling quick draw is definitely a plus, and to pair with quick draw, something like moving target to increase that aim assistance, and also no distractions to help with reduced flinching. Not top tier perks by any means, but they will help out with some basic functioning of the weapon. I know some people are hopping on the Widow's Bite train as well. I've just never been a fan of the rapid fire frame snipers in PvP. I don't feel strong with them, and I just have never been able to use them with the same effectiveness as adaptive and aggressive frame snipers. If I'm just completely forgetting a weapon to replace Beloved, then let me know in the comments, but I was having a very hard time finding something that would do something even close to what the Beloved does for a lot of players. In my opinion, you'd be better off using the Eye of Soul, as it's the same archetype, and it has good perk combinations. Moving on to a favorite amongst PvP players, the Mindbender's Ambition. The Mindbender's has definitely had its share of the Crucible spotlight. I would say probably 8 months ago now, this was the special weapon to have and use in the Crucible, as not very many people had a good role, let alone even had one in their inventory. The only way you could get Mindbenders is from the chest at the end of the Hallowed Lair Nightfall Strike, and it was about a 1 in 6 chance that you would even get it to drop, which meant hours upon hours upon hours of doing the same strike whenever it showed up in the Nightfall playlist. Luckily, last season, Destiny 2 players were hit with a quest that turned out to be a very formidable replacement and also a blast from Destiny 1's past, the Fellwinter's Lie. If you were fortunate enough to play back in Season of the Worthy, then you hopefully completed that quest that allowed you to get this weapon. I'm not going to spend a ton of time talking about Fellwinters because most of you probably already know a bunch about it, and if you don't, then you're probably like, okay bro, but how does that help me if I don't have it? To which I would say, listen close. Because even though a very obvious choice would be to use the Trial Shotgun Astral Horizon, I still am sticking with my rule of finding replacements within the same slot. although Astral is definitely a formidable replacement. A shotgun I want you to try out is the Seraph CQC-12. And even though it's not the same archetype as the Mindbenders, the Seraph shotgun definitely has potential as it can roll both quick draw and snapshot at the same time. It's also very farmable right now through Umbral Engrams as well, making it extremely accessible to get that specific roll. The good thing right now is that range on shotguns aren't as crucial as they were back in the day. The most important thing with shotguns right now is their pellet spread, and how consistent they can keep that tight pellet spread. Felwinter's has its exclusive perk shot package, which creates a more consistent pellet spread with each shot. The Seraph shotgun does not have that, but it has the right perks to make it effective in PvP. Give it a shot, you might be surprised. All right, the moment you've all been waiting for, or maybe you've just skipped to this part of the video, but either way, let's talk about Recluse, everyone's PvE Swiss Army knife. Out of all the weapons to go, I think Recluse is going to be the one that I'm going to miss the most. Not because it doesn't have any replacements, because it surely does, we'll get to that in a second, but because this thing has been through the dang gauntlet with me, and I would assume all of you as well. Any PvE content that was thrown our way, Recluse was always the go-to DPS ad clearing weapon for our loadout. So what in the world is going to fill those shoes? I've actually got three different options to replace our good friend, with an honorable mention at the end. So let's first talk about the obvious one that everyone probably knows about and has already used, Gnawing Hunger. Yes, that Gnawing Hunger that is also littering the Crucible. It too is capable of rolling some really good perks for PvE as well. Pair Subsistence with either Rampage, Multi-Kill Clip, or Swashbuckler, and you've got yourself an ad-clearing DPS machine that definitely fills the shoes of Recluse. But I've got some other options for those of you that like to be anti-meta or that just don't like using auto rifles in PvE. The next gun I'm going to recommend is the legendary sidearm, Last Hope. Now, even though it's a sidearm, Last Hope can be a damage-producing machine with some great perk combinations. I have one that has Feeding Frenzy and Rampage, and this thing just straight up annihilates all trash mobs and even does some work to powerful enemies as well. It has a ton of great perk combinations, so find one that suits your playstyle. Last Hope can be found through regular legendary loot drops throughout the world. If you're wanting to fill an exotic slot to replace your Recluse, then look no further than the Trinity Ghoul. It's a bow, it electrocutes stuff, what more could you want? With Trinity Ghoul's Catalyst, you will evaporate any group of enemies that you choose to decimate. This weapon is very satisfying and extremely fun to use in PvE. 10 out of 10 would recommend. With the Catalyst, of course. And the honorable mention to replace our Recluse is its Season 11 doppelganger, Death Adder. The Death Adder was re-released into the loot pool this season as part of the new dungeon, The Prophecy. The Death Adder can be earned as a reward from the chests within the dungeon. The only reason it's in my honorable mention slot is that it doesn't quite have the perks that I would want my DPS slash ad clearing weapon to have. It does have some decent perks, but overall it just doesn't put up the same results as the other weapons I mentioned do. Nonetheless, it's still a viable option, should you choose to not use any of the other three that I recommended. If I missed any weapons that could be used to replace any of these going forward, please let me know down in the comments. Also, if there are any other weapons that you would like me to address and find replacements for, reply to my pinned comment and I will make another video on them. Again, if you enjoy this type of content, click the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. We are closer and closer to the YouTube partnership requirements, and every view, sub, and comment helps out my channel immensely. Links to all of my affiliate discounts as well as my socials are in the description box below. Thank you all very much for watching. A positive rating is always appreciated, and as always, we'll see ya.